Everyone, hope that you are well. Today I want to bring a very important lighting parameter into our discussion. So today's video will be about the unified glare rating. And before I start working in Dialux Evo, I just want to let you know what does mean glare, first of all. And I want to let you know that it's the glare. It's defined as a difficulty of seeing in the presence of bright light, such as direct or reflected light sources, such sunlight or artificial light. So to simplify the definition, I will jump to the first picture, which I think is very important, and it summarizes all the sources of glare which can be encountered in our daily work, in our environment, especially indoor application speaking. So we have the direct natural glare, which is coming, of course, from the sun. We have the direct glare, which is coming from the artificial lighting sources. So this means our luminaires. And we have also reflective glare, which is representing, for let's say, the reflection of the light from the artificial light from a laptop screen, for example, or if you work via PC, then it's the reflection of the artificial light from the monitor of the PC. So bear in mind with this picture, I think it's very important to know when you design a space, let's say for office and commercial application, is very important this lighting parameter. So now moving back to the Dialux Evo, but before starting working, if you did not subscribe to my YouTube channel, please do so. Please give a thumbs up to the video and yeah, let's start working and defining the unified glare rating. How you calculate it? I already established the, let's say I choose already the luminaires for this space, as you can see in the following preview. So these are the four luminaires. I will switch to the 2D view. So we have four luminaires, a classic small office, I would say, just to represent and show you how you calculate the UGR. And now you need to go on the calculation objects, switch to 2D to be much easier to introduce. First, you need to introduce the calculation object. We will go with rectangular, of course, and each dot that you see in this calculation surface, it represent a point for the UGR value. And now we have a calculation surface. We need to position because now if I move to 3D, it's on the floor level. You need to place it like eye of server, which should be 0.85. As you can see it now in this view. Next step, we will go to the calculation parameters. You need to check the unified glare rating. So this one, not the glare rating. Glare rating you are using only for outdoor workplaces. And then the high offset we established already. We have high offset, I put 85. We go what a step width, which is from the horizontal point of view of eye level of the observer, which is 50 degrees, we remain the same. And here, usually by default, you have 360, but I would say you need to place 180 because from this point where you are sitting, you can just see, 180. You cannot see only if you rotate your chair on the other direction to have the 300. So 180, these are the setup that you need to do. Space. I define it already like standard office. So for standard office, we need to have a UGR less than 19. So this is already pre-stable in our calculation, let's say. Setting for measuring grid, I will let automatic. You can go also manually if you want distance or quantity, it's up to you. And the needs automatic, I will let also for isoline. You can choose also manual, so up to you. Here I will let the same value chart settings to keep it simple. And Now I will just start the lighting calculation. So we have to introduce the calculation surface. Here you can say, let's say UGR, let's say 1. So we name also the calculation, and here positioning everything set up correctly. And as well, we will go for the perpendicular illuminance, of course, on this table, and then we'll have the value of the unified gray rating. So let's start the calculation now and see the results. Of course, you can, I would say the most important is here, where the person is working. So you need to have the as lower UGR as possible. You know, as I mentioned earlier, for office, usually UGR should be less than 19. So let's see the calculation on related to UGR. Here we have a UGR 15.8, so we are below 19. You see minimum is 10, is calculated. The target, as mentioned earlier, because we choose already in an office, is pre-stable to be below 19. So we are fulfilling. We have also the green checkbox, let's say there. And also the parameters which we included in the calculation. Of course, the lux level is 500, which is typical for the office, and also the uniformity, it's good. So yeah, that's a simple way how you can calculate the UGR value and get the feedback of your related to your space. And here we can put also as well, let's say the luminaires, so you have an overview how actually it's looking. So yeah, more views, for example, and you see that it's, yeah, perpendicular the ISO lines on the table. So that's the configuration. I would say if you want to do, for example, a second, we can repeat for the circle table. We can do a similar. Oh yeah, results will start over again. So we start all over again, same parameters, offset. We will let it like this. You just need to the positioning to be defined, and everything starts from there. I would say we can put, yeah, let's say if our server is here and you want another surface, we place it like here. In this case, let's say we can place it at, let's say 1.5, 1.7 meters. I think this one is more concluded. This one I can delete because more or less will be the same same results like the previous one, but I think this one it's will be very interesting. If we put on 1.7, let's say the observer is standing, it's not sitting at this moment, and let's see the which values, the properties here, UGR, we can put 2. I'm curious what will be the result in this case. So you can put, you can play, let's say, with different areas in that space to determine the UGR values. Of course, you can make it for all space, but in this case, I just want to show that you can do it on the test area where the people are working. That's the most important. And then you can put also, for example, yeah, when someone is standing and see the value. So if you put on 1.7, this is just by default, you see that we're on 21. So this is already too high in this case. So that's really interesting to see that if a person is standing and you put this one on 1.7, then you are, yeah, and you face the luminaire on the same angle of 50 degrees, definitely you get, let's say, the UGR, you have the glare higher than 19. Of course, this will not be the case, but just to get an overview how it works and how you can establish different, let's play once again. Upgrade 1.5. I'm just curious what's happening. Just have a first fast calculation, and then I want to show you actually from the visual point of view what does it mean, a luminaire which it's glare, you know, just providing glare, and let's say we call it glare free, so a luminaire which have a better uniformity. So you see, if you go on low light, so we reduce the height, then of course the GRR is getting better. So here if I go 1 meter, so definitely, or 1.2 meters, we will go to 19. So this will fulfill the requirement. But as mentioned, the most important is on the task area. So 0.85, that's there you need to calculate the UGR. Good. Let's move now with the picture that I want to show you. I think this is very important from the, as I mentioned, from visual point of view, to see two luminaires on the right and left, where yeah, their glare is provided, let's say, and you see high brightness, and it's causing a really a discomfort. So another thing which I want to mention is there are two types of glare. We speak about the discomfort glare, and we have disability glare. Discomfort is just high brightness direct into your eyes, and you feel uncomfort, and you need to move on. You cannot just watch that high brightness for too much time. Let's say the disability glare, it's produced more for the reflection part of a laptop or magazine. We had glossy paper, for example, which is reflecting the, as mentioned earlier, the sunlight or the artificial light. So going back to Dialux, I hope that everything is clear. If you have questions about how you establish that, how you can calculate, please let your message in the comment section box. And yeah, as mentioned earlier, subscribe to my channel, give a thumbs up to this video. And until next time, wish you all the best. Take care. Bye-bye.